for over a year we've been talking about this opportunity, and I think everyone's going to have a fantastic time. My name is Stephanie Shaw, and I'm the Executive Director of Eastern Ohio Education Partnership. We're an education consortium, and we cover Trumbull, Mahoney, Ashtabula, and Columbiana counties. Our partnership is having this event tonight as a fundraiser for our organization, so our board and our staff say thank you very much for attending. As a partnership, we have four strategic goals. We're working very closely with educators in the area on increasing kindergarten readiness, assuring that our students are ready to read when they get to third grade, eighth grade math readiness, and also post-secondary career readiness. Those are four areas where the students usually struggle. They're strong transition points. And as a consortium, we work with folks in the four counties on making sure that those transition points are a lot smoother. We do that with a data-driven way of doing things. We look at the data, figure out what programs are actually working in the school, and then we move forward with what's working best and help the school districts to grow those initiatives. So I thank you so much for being here tonight and helping support education in our four county area. Before we get started, I want to thank Joe Augustine for being here tonight and Al Bright. I'm so happy, so excited about tonight for several reasons. One, I can't wait to see what Mr. Bright creates for us, and also because it's over, almost. It's been a long road. It's been very, very exciting, and I've loved having conversations with Mr. Bright about how this all takes place and some of the other work that he's done. And I was telling him earlier, I got moved up in cool mom status because my kids were like, you know Al Bright, so cool. So it's been a great journey. I want to thank our sponsor. Have you seen their names have been scrolling on the screen here? They include Metro Monthly, Home Plate, The Vindicator, Toyota of Warren, Pipefitters Local 396, Greenwood Chevrolet, Blair & Littell, Stiefel, and CenturyLink. We also have table sponsors, and I thank you all for being here. Dr. Kenneth LaCalla, Diane Sauer Chevrolet, Packer Thomas, and Eastern Gateway Community College. When you walked in the room, you should have received a postcard. If you did not, make sure that you get one before you leave. We also had some restaurant sponsors. Because this will be a very laid-back, entertaining evening, we won't, be auctioning off anything or asking you to purchase. Well, kind of asking you to purchase something else, but not a lot of stuff. We decided that we're having hors d'oeuvres tonight, and then after, we'd like for you guys to solicit some of our local restaurants in the area. And B2, Vernon, and also the Chop House, and we agreed to give everyone a discount if they go tonight. So you have that information on your card. And if you flip your card over, Mr. Bright has been gracious enough to allow us to print the piece that he does tonight. So those are also available for sale. And those are back on the left-hand side over there. You can go, we ask that you not go during the presentation, of course, but they're after the event, you can go back there and purchase those prints. To my volunteers, Lee Marquez, Peg Crozier, Shirley Brady, Danielle Dillon, Jeremy Leidig, Andy Bethar, Janine Morris, Becky Kett, thank you guys so much. And to my great friend and former college buddy, Rob Fabiano at the Metro Monthly and Home Plate. He did the commercial that I'm sure many of you have seen and has actually volunteered his services tonight. And that is so gracious of him. I really appreciate it, Ron. Thank you so much. I am governed by a board of directors, and there are a few of my board members here today, and I'm going to ask them to stand. One I see sitting here. I saw Tony somewhere, too. Where's Tony? I think Dr. Meeks may be here also. Hey, Tony, Dr. Meeks. Thank you guys so much. Laura Meeks, Eastern Gateway Community College, Tony Paglia, who's the Vice President at the Regional Chamber, and Nicole Ferrara with Packer Thomas. Thank you guys very much for coming. I am going to step off the stage because you did not come here to see me. You came to see Mr. Bright, and I am going to hand the mic over to him and have him get started.
This evening for this hopefully an extraordinary experience. It's extraordinary in my own mind because generally, when we see art in the galleries, the museums, we don't see the creative process. We see the byproduct of that creative process. Because most artists, as I have in my career, we paint in private or we create in private. And sometimes we don't want anyone to see our process or to see our technique and so forth until the work is selected and put into a gallery. And that's only part of the whole experience. See, the whole experience is a human experience. We all as human beings are endowed with the ability to create. We're the only species on this planet that art comes very natural to us. Every child, in time, all the way through history, all the way through time, has picked up an instrument, scribbled on our walls, stick figures evolve from that. They start explaining their anxiety, their joys, and their pains. They start seeing the world through their art. Art is the most natural element in the human species. And we don't stop creating it until we arrive at puberty, where we cannot accept rejection. And if your work doesn't look like somebody else's work, and that other person's getting accolades, and you're still doing stick figures, and they're doing exotic, realistic, natural things, you move on because you can't stand rejection, and then you move on to try to find something else to fill that gap. But every one of us loves art, and there are many closet artists in this room who are still doodling at the boardroom tables, expressing yourselves. More people are going to arts events, and this is a statistic that is a fact. More people are attending art events in our world than they are organized sports, 80,000 seats, studio, stadiums. That's happening every day. Art is forever more important than sports. And that is what I'm wanting to present in the last 45 to 48 years of my life, is to take some of my work outside of the studio and to paint it before live audiences, to live music, to perform with geniuses who are doing something incredible in terms of music. See, music and visual arts are very closely related. Theirs is auditory, mine is visual. We share a common language. They talk about tonality, value, rhythm, patterns, all of that. We have the same thing in the visual arts as well. So I'm going to paint the color of these geniuses' work tonight. I'm going to ride on the genius and the rhythms that they're providing in sound, and I'm going to produce it in my work through pigment. And not only that, I'm going to feel the ebb and flow of your anxiety as the piece emerges. I'm going to start with a blank canvas. I'm going to paint a la prima. I have no preconceived notion of what the final results will be. I have no notion of what colors are going to go on this piece. But I know there's going to come a time in this room when you all will feel a closure, when this thing is coming to a complete cyclical relationship with the music and the ebb and flow of the audience. You're going to see things here that you want to be stationary. I'm going to destroy it, recreate it, and you're going to feel that ebb and flow. But ultimately, you'll have your own aesthetic experience, and I hope it's going to be wonderful. I cannot have an aesthetic experience with my own work because the artist cannot have psychological distance away from that to be objective. But I hope you will. Hope you'll have a good time, and that you'll relax, open your mind, and for the time it takes for us to bring all of this together, I hope you'll have an experience that will open your mind to a higher level of appreciation for the beauty of art and the human experience. So I thank you for coming, and relax. Okay? Thank you.
Thank you. doing, Alphonse?
I'm doing fine. How are you, man?
I'm great, baby.
You are cooking.
You are cooking.
Thank you.
I wrote it for you.
You got it. Amen.
Thank you.
I hope you enjoyed the energy that we provided. And I had a wonderful time. I felt your vibes. I felt your pain at certain points. No, I even felt the hook one time. A fool is one who doesn't know how to stop after he's made his point. But when you see this now in a museum or a gallery, you know, it'll be a personal experience for you, because it's just a matter of pouring out your energy a la prima, not fearing, because if we can get over fear, we can reach a deeper level of our humanity and our potential. We're invincible as a human being. We have so much more power than we waste through fear. So if we just loosen up, let it go, we can love more, feel more, give more. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. It was a pleasure. Stephanie, thank you for this wonderful opportunity. As you know, I love Al. I don't know why he loves me, but he does. I would like to introduce to you my two colleagues this evening, two genius musicians. On bass, Timothy W. Powell. In Ohio, Glenn Davis. The night is young, enjoy. Thanks for giving us the opportunity to do what God gave us to do. Thank you.
Thank you once again. Thank you, Joe. Awesome job tonight. Thank you again. For everyone that came on tonight, again, I really do appreciate you supporting education. Now, education is very, very important. STEM is important, but more importantly, because I'm the mother of artists, art is so, so important. And that's something we have to make sure that we're incorporating into our students' education. Just as another quick reminder, this will be hanging in a gallery somewhere, but you do have the opportunity to purchase a print that you can hang in your home or at your place of business, and those opportunities are over there to your left. Again, thank you very much to my board members for coming out tonight. I truly appreciate it. I appreciate our sponsors, with our lead sponsors being Metro Monthly, the Vindicator, and also Toyota Warren. We thank you so much for your generosity. And thank you, Dee. There she is. Because without a Dee, that's Mr. Bright's wife right there. We were sitting in a meeting and she mentioned this, and I'm like, I've never been to that. That sounds so exciting. And she, I really appreciate you allowing me the opportunity to work with your husband and putting on this event. Again, also thank you to our t-shirt sponsor. If you saw the great shirts that everyone had on, Charlie Staples Famous Barbecue and Charlie Staples, he donated a full cup of love for everyone. So we thank you guys for that also. Do you have anything else to say?
No, I just invite you to come up and look at it closely. It'll take a long time for it to cure, because this is oil on canvas and oil never dries. It cures. And it will look like this 500 years from now or more, because it breathes with the canvas. It's painted on canvas. The canvas breathes, expands and contracts. The oil is breathing with the canvas. And the colors and the sheen and the vibrancy of it will last forever until someone attacks it. So come up closely, smell the oils, and I'll see you on the radio.
Thank you all once again for this.
Let me get people together before you guys come. have to send me that.
Oh, I want that.
You shoot the video too?
Uh-huh.
Is that high def?
Mm-hmm.
Is it? Can you get high def? How about the music? Is it digital music? Is it? Something like this, what do you get?
I can donate.
Why are you donating? Somebody hired you for to do an hour and a half thing.
Not quite that. It comes about $500.
You will have for less than $500?
Probably $300.
$300? You got a card on you?
No, I can come all out of the
Where are you from?
I'm from Warren. I produce the local television show.
That's a high-def camera?
Yes.
Is that what they use on TV? TV?
Yes.
Valentine's.